translators can come to is kind of the word in English, Papa. And so what he's saying is, Papa, is there any other way? And I've read it 100 times, but when I read it, I find myself hoping, God, tell him there is another way. You know, like when Abraham thought he had to sacrifice his son, and when he came to it, you didn't let him do it, and you provided another way. Remember the ram and the bushes? Tell him that he's not the only way. Tell him that he's just one of many ways. Tell him there's many ways to come back to you. But there's this little white space after in your Bibles, after he asked that question and before the next letter of the next sentence. And it's this big, broad, white space that just begs for something to be written there. But what we find is that the silence is deafening. You see, if all ways lead to God, then God made a terrible mistake. If Jesus is not the only way, then what he endured for us on the cross was not sacrificial, it was a needless waste. There's no way to honor one and to believe the other. It was completely unnecessary. I respect anyone's choice, just as God does. You can reject Jesus as the only way, but you can't lump Jesus into the many ways lead back to God pile. The story of Jesus simply will not allow it. To reject Jesus is the only way. You must reject the story, the biblical story of Jesus. That's the question Jesus is really asking. Abba, is there any other way those whom we love